Miranda? What are you doing?
I'm really busy. I can't go on stage right now.
Miranda, you have to go on. They are waiting for you.
Okay, well, I'm really busy, so I can't go on right now. So figure something else out. I have to tingle.
Okay. I guess Miranda isn't ready. So, please, put your hands together for... Colleen Bum-ble-bee-ee!
Way louder, right? So before every show, I see all these flashes going off and I'm a diva, and so you guys have to turn off your phones. I'm just kidding. Take as many pictures as you want tonight. Post them on Twitter, Instagram, anywhere you want, and hashtag Miranda Sings Minneapolis, and that way we can look through all the pictures later tonight. Okay, so I know you guys are wanting to see Miranda, but she's not ready, so I am going to sing a couple songs, if that's cool. This first song is a song that's very near and dear to my heart, because it's about two things that I'm very close to these days, and one is coffee, and the other is stalkers. So this song is called Taylor the Latte Boy. There's a boy who works at Starbucks who is very inspirational. He is very inspirational because of many things. I come in at 11 and he smiles and says, "How are you?" When he smiles and says, "How are you?" I could swear my heart crows wings. So today at 8:11, I decided I should meet him. I decided I should meet him in a proper, formal way. So today at 8:11, when he smiled and said, "How are you?" I said, "Fine, and my name's Carol." And he softly answered, "Hey." And I said, "My name is Carol, and thank you for the extra foam." And he said his name was Taylor, which provides the inspiration for this poem. In the basement of a bar, and he smoothly flipped the lever to prepare my double latte. But for me, he made it triple, and he didn't think I knew. But I saw him flip the lever to prepare my triple latte, and I knew that triple latte meant that Taylor loved me too. I said, "What time are you playing? And thank you for the extra skim." Keep the $3.55 because this triple latte was on him.
Who'd have thought that love could be so captivating?
I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second kissing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and leave. And you can't pull me down.
Love you, Colleen.
I love doing charity work, so I thought, oh, I'll perform for you as charity. And while doing that, I can teach you guys how to be better people in a world full of porn. So tonight is not just a concert. I'm not just going to sing for you. Tonight is actually a lesson for you guys, and this is my self-help tour. So tonight, I'm going to be teaching you a seminar on how to be a better person. But before we get into the seminar portion of the show, I think it is very important that you guys respect me as a human being and as an artist. Because, you know, I want you guys to know where I came from, how I got to be here, so that you understand that my advice is very important and you should listen to what I say. So I'm going to start the show with a little history on myself so you guys can see what I've been through, seeing my struggles and my successes. So a lot of people ask me, Miranda, when did you get famous? How did you get famous? The answer is, I always been famous. It's just now people know. So, what's a better question is, Miranda, when did you start singing? And I started singing from birth, of course. And I have written the scene of the very first time that I ever sang. And I'm going to perform the scene of my birth in front of your eyes right now. But I can't do it on my own because the scene is between my mom, because she gave birth to me, and my uncle, because he... So I'm going to need help from someone. Oh, you're right. Hi, what's your name?
Zach,
it's nice to meet you.
Me too.
Looking really good tonight.
Thank you.
You look really nice.
Me too.
No offense. Don't touch. So, Zach, I have this for you.
Okay.
This is a script. So you'll be playing the role of my mother, and I'll be playing the role of my uncle. But since you're about to give birth, you, of course, need to be pregnant. So I'm going to put... We have to make you pregnant, so we have to put this in your shirt. Love your outfit, by the way. So let's put it in. Oh, but don't put it in all the way because you're about to give birth. So it's just not like the head is sticking out. I can see the head. Get it? So. All right, so are you ready? All right, and scene.
Oh, I'm so pregnant. Oh.
Oh, how are you doing, dear sister-in-law? I'm so excited for you to give birth to this baby. I love little girls. Oh, do you need a poo massage?
No, it's not a poo, it's a baby. Oh, I'm so pregnant. I just know it, I am.
Let's get you to the hospital. Ho, 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 I'm the nurse. I've come to get this baby out from you. Just push from your tukey really hard. And breathe lacrosse breathing like this. Hee, 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 hee. Ho, ho, ho.
Hee, 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 ho, ho, ho.
Hope you smell fertile. If it smells fertile, that's what they say. Now push.
Ouchie.
I've been burned. I don't need you. I can just do it myself. So you can leave. So give him a round of applause, everybody. Okay, sleep good in your bed. I've got to go cook some chicken tenders for your uncle. I wish I could be
Professional. First thing you need to do when you're a singer is warm up your voice. This warms up your voice. So how you do that is you sing notes on a scale. You go up and down the notes, and that's a scale. So for example, so that's a scale. Now you try a scale. Okay, not quite. Next thing you can try is singing a word. I like to use the word bumblebee. So for example, bumblebee, bumblebee. So now you try bumblebee. Stop, words are way too advanced for you. So I recommend just sticking to awe from now on. Now normally we would do this for a few hours to make sure your vocal cords are really warmed up. But we don't have that type of time because I want you to leave. So we're just going to... Well, I'm not done, so...
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can leave if you want, but...
No,
I just... Okay, this is really awkward. You Minneapolisans. Okay, so... Next, we're going to work on something called vibrato. Vibrato is that shaking sound that your voice makes. How you get a vibrato is you shake a part of your body and it shakes your voice. So, for example... I shake my head, so... You try a vibrato. That's pretty good, actually. So let's just skip right into a song, okay? Let's not waste any more time. We'll just sing a simple little song, Mary Had a Little Lamb. So just simply go, Mary had a little lamb. Okay, so try that.
Mary had a little lamb.
Okay, that was awful. I'm going to teach you something that I give to most of my students. A lot of celebrities use this technique these days. This is called lip syncing. So you're going to lip sync to me and see if it helps. I'm ready? Mary had a little lamb. You sound so much better. So my biggest recommendation for you would be don't sing. So try that next time you have to sing something. And other than that, I think that's all I'm going to do with you today. So thank you for coming. Thank you. So that's how to give a voice lesson, my friends. And now, tonight I'm going to take you through my self-help program and teach you how to be better people. We're going to cover four topics. These are the four most important topics in life, I think. If you can conquer these four, you'll be a great person. Let's get into it. The topics are porn, love, bullies, self-esteem. So let's go ahead and get started. The first topic, of course, is Miranda on porn. There is a lot of porn in the world these days, and it's really disgusting. And it's my job to make sure that you guys do not participate in the porn actions of the world. There's lots of different types of porn, by the way, so I want to cover some of those right now. But for the first type of porn, I'm going to need a couple helpers. So let's see. Now, you are the first hand I saw coming up, and then I need one more person. Oh, there's so many options. So many options. Yeah, you in the black. Yeah, you in the black. Okay, come on up. All right, so, hello. So, let me get my pointer so that I can make this more clear. I need to get my pointer, so... Oh, it's stuck. Okay. So, what is your name?
I'm Georgia.
Georgia. Nice to meet you, Georgia. So the first type of porn we're going to be talking about is porn clothing, okay? So this is a bootiful outfit. We have the nice shirt button all the way to the top, nice long sleeve arms, pants pulled tight and taut up all the way down to the floor. Very respectable outfit, looks really good. This is a perfect example of not porn. This is porn. I can see most of your arms. I'm not even kidding. You're wearing the high hooker heels. Your shirt is sucked down so low, I can see your chesticle crack. And your pants are too tight. I can see all the lady lumps and crevices. So,
This is an example of porn. What is your name?
Lacey.
Exactly. So, this is an example of not porn. This is porn. I highly recommend you dress like this. There are two ways to not be porn when you're dressing yourself. One, dress like us. We look really good. Number two, I have created something called the anti-porn unicorn, okay? And I have something with me today that this really helps with the porn clothes that people have these days. So this is the anti-porn unicorn horn. Pop this baby on, and then whenever you see someone being porn, you can just be like, stop it! Hit them right in the porn areas or the porn holes to get rid of all those disgusting things. It'll really teach them a lesson, teach them not to dress that way anymore. So, I think you guys are well educated now on how to not dress porn, so give them a round of applause. One type of porn is porn clothing. Unfortunately, that's not the only type of porn we encounter every day. There's also a lot of porn in music, my friends. Thanks a lot, Miley Cyrus, for ruining the radio. So there's porn in music, and there's also porn in words. And then push them together, and then it's porn music. So I want my Mirfandas to be able to go out and enjoy the club without being disgusting and being porn. So I have created a way that you can enjoy this music without being disgusting and participating in the porn halls. So what we're going to do is I'm going to sing you a song of all the worst porn songs I heard on the radio, and I'm going to change them to be not porn, okay? So this is my porn medley, not porn style. Hit it. My neck, my back, wipe my tookie and my crack. My neck, my back, wipe my tookie and my crack. It's getting hot in here, let's drink some lemonade. I am getting so hot, I'm gonna drink some water. Like you want me to, and we'll boil it right, steam it all through the night. I'll make corn with me, cause I may be good, but I'm perfectly good at it. Breath in the air, I don't care, I love the smell of it. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but Taco Bell excites me. Thinking, oh Miranda, I don't even have a boyfriend. How can we talk about love? Well, Good luck for you. I'm going to teach you tonight how to get a boyfriend. I'm not even kidding. So, unfortunately, if you are interested in women, though, I cannot help you out. I only am educated on how to get a boyfriend. I'm not interested in women because I'm not Lebanese. So I can only help you if you like the boys. So here we go. How to get a boyfriend. You need three things to get a boyfriend. That's all you need. Just three simple things. And they are 1, booty. 2, brains. 3, talent, okay? That's all you need. So let's go through these. 1, of course, you have to be bootiful in order to get a boyfriend. Otherwise, no one's gonna wanna be with you. That's easy. 2, brains. You have to be smart if you wanna get a boyfriend. It's very easy to show off how smart you are when you meet a man. Just be like, oh, and start adding and subtracting, something like that. For me, I show off how smart I am by speaking in other languages. So whenever I meet a man, I just immediately start singing in another language, because not only does it prove how smart I am, but it also shows that I'm not a racist. So this is a song I always sing to the men when I meet them. This song is in Mexican, and I hope you like it. You're listening. Good little Mirfandas. Talent, of course. Now, obviously, I'm not lacking in this area, so it's very easy for me to get a boyfriend. But for you, I would highly recommend doing whatever your talent is right when you meet a boy. So right after I sing my song about me, you know, singing in Mexican, I always like to jump right into another song to really show off my talents. So I sing, but you can do whatever you want, whether that's being a magician or soap, whatever it is that you do best. So I'm going to sing, but I'm not just going to sing anything. Always go above and beyond, because there's lots of peoples with your talents, so you have to prove that you're better than all of them. And how I'm going to do that is I sing a song that is all the best songs from the last year. So that proves that I can sing any type of singing by any type of artist, and it's a medley of songs. So right when I meet a boy, I just jump into the song. Not only that, but I also add one other element, which is props. I have my prop box here. Men love to know that you can use a prop, so. All right, so I'll just get my props all ready here, so I'll just give me a second, so. Just give me 1 second, so I can fix my props, so I'll just give me a minute, so. Just set it up, okay, so. This is the song that I sing to the men to get them. Hit it. Everybody get up!
Magic.
bought my ticket for the long way round. Two bottles of whiskey for the way. You're gonna miss me by my hair. You're gonna miss me everywhere. Oh, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. When I'm gone. When I'm gone.
Beautiful tonight.
I know. You look really good, so.
Thanks. I like your horse.
Thank you, me too. Do you want to pet it?
Sure. Okay.
I see. So let me just take this off before we do our scene. Slip into something a little more comfortable.
All right.
I did. So, are you ready to do our scene?
Yeah.
So this is the scene of our breakup. We've been working on this a lot. I have blocked this and directed it all by myself. So, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's do it. Scene.
How great thou art!
See you next Sunday, Michael.
Oh, wait, Miranda. I forgot to tell you. My family and I are moving, so this is the last Sunday you're gonna see me.
So what does this mean?
I guess it means we won't be seeing each other anymore.
You're leaving me?
Well, all of Tacoma... really... It is a bummer, right?
So, you're just going to break up with me then?
Miranda, I think you're confused. We were never dating, we were just friends.
I know, because you just broke up with me. You don't have to rub it in my face. You've said enough. After all the crackers and grape juice we shared together.
Listen, Miranda. I'm sorry. I will miss you, though. Goodbye.
Stop trying to kiss me! Stop kissing me! We already broke up! So awkward!
We didn't rehearse that.
Okay, if you insist, I guess we have to kiss, so.
Guys, I have a girlfriend.
Yeah, woo! Right. Just give me a kiss.
On the mouth. Okay, we didn't rehearse the song. We didn't rehearse the song.
Okay, just in the words, I'll be here.
Summer loving, happy in the past.
Summer loving, happy so fast.
I met a girl. Crazy for me.
I met the bum. You were there, mate.
Summer days drifting away to another summer night.
Oh, well, oh, well, oh, well, oh. Tell me more, tell me more. Like, does he have a car? Tell me more, tell me more. Like, does he have a car?
She's been by me. She got a crayon. Saved her life, she nearly drowned.
He went off, watching around.
Summer sun, something begun to other summer nights.
It turned colder, that's where it's in.
So I told her we'd still be friends.
Then we made our true love.
I wonder what she's doing now.
Summer dreams ripped at the seams, but
breakup. It's about a lot of different women who went through a hard time and got revenge on a man. And I'm going to be playing all the roles. I also choreographed this myself. This is Cell Block Tango. Pump. Pump. Sis. Tongue down. Sis. Cicerone. Lynchings. Pop, sit, squinch. Oh, Cicerone. Lynchings. Pop, sit, squinch. Oh, Cicerone. Lynchings. He had to call me. He had to call me. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same. Pop, sit, squinch. Oh, Cicerone. Lynchings. I was standing in the kitchen carving up a turkey for dinner. It starts by his man Wilbur and Johnson Range. You've been kissing a milkman, he said. He was crazy. He kept screaming, you've been kissing a milkman. Then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done it. Lutchis more than I could say. He was a real artistic guy, an artist. But he's always out trying to find himself. He'd go on every night, and on the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Ruth. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself dead. He saw himself alive. And I saw him dead. The dirty bum bum. Dirty bum, bum, bum. He had to call me. He had to call me. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same. You pop that gum one more time, single my butt 10 times. Pop. Six. School. Oh. You guys, how to deal with bullies. There are tons of bullies in the world these days. I get tweets every single day from you guys. They're like, oh, Miranda, my mom keeps bullying me. And I just want to help you guys get through these awful times in your life. So, of course, there had to be a bully section of my show. Now, what you guys don't know is that there's lots of different types of bullies. Just there's lots of types. So, let's get straight into it. Different types of bullies. Bullies at home. This could be parents, uncles, pets, carpets. So there's a lot of different ways to deal with it. You know, your mom tells you to clean your room, you're just like, stop it, get out! Or you can hide in the closet, that's what I like to do. How you can deal with other kind of bullies at home is you can kick them, like carpets or pets. So let's go to the next one. Bullies who are strangers. Now this could be school people or homeless people. People at school are really rude. Teachers always giving you homework. Bullies as homeless people on the street. Give me some money. Nick, y'all right? Just yell at them. So, that's the type of bullies. Bullies online, which could be haters. Now this is the type of bullying I deal with every single day of my life. I'm the most familiar with bullies online, which are these haters. Now, if you don't know what hater is, a hater is a rude, mean person who writes awful things all over the internet. For me, they write them all over my YouTube, all over my Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, everything. They're always writing really rude, mean things, using lots of bad words, not speaking English good. So that's how you know if it's a hater. So, what I want to do, this is what I say to my haters. Haters back off, and that usually does the trick. But I want you guys to understand what I have to go through every single day for you. So, I brought some hate mail with me tonight that I'm going to read to you. So you guys can see what I have to deal with. And how this is going to work is I'm going to show you a video from my YouTube channel, and then I will read you hate mail I got after I posted that video, okay? So the very first video I want to show you is very near and dear to my heart. This video was my very first video to hit 1 million views, so it's very special to me. It was filmed on the beach. This is Starship.
I own that, and they ain't paying my rent this month, I owe that. But be who you want, be who you like, dance all night, there's no one that's right. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. If you a G, you a G, G, G. My name is Miranda, you can call me Miranda. I'm on the floor, I love to dance, and I'm a like two last chances, get on the floor. Starships will make you fly, and touch the sky.
There you go. That's so unfortunately, I got hate mail after that, if you can believe it. And I'm going to read it to you, but I must warn you to close your eyes while you're reading this if you don't want to get hurt. There are lots of bad words, which I will be bleeping out for you. So let's get to it. WWWW. Is this B word beeping for real? Nasty, get the beep away from those kids. You look like some retrotted raw pest, and you sing like beep. If I ever see this beep, 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 I'ma knock you out. Smash your face in that sand and stomp on your head till you shut the beep up for good. That was so bad I couldn't even listen to the whole thing. Sad face, my ear are burned. I now have ear cancer. Congratulations, you captured my love for music, ate it, and threw it up in a dumpster. Then you took it out of that dumpster, raped it, aborted it, and cooked it in a stew and fed it back to me. Anyway, good luck on your career being an ugly joke. You reigned. Really, really. Next one, please. No. Stop singing, listen to yourself, and compare it to real singers. You sound like you're pooing. How'd you know what I sound like when I'm doing that anyway? So, gotcha. So, the next video I want to show you, it's really hard for me to watch, actually, because I don't just sing on my YouTube channel. I do a lot of vlogs, tutorials, whatever you want, really. And this next video was the most requested video I have ever gotten in my whole entire life. You guys begged me to do this, so finally I did it. Little did I know you guys were trying to kill me. This is the worst thing I ever even did. It was so awful, I almost died. So this is, of course, the Cinnamon Challenge.
I'm here, and I don't really see why this is going to be a challenge, because I love cinnamon, so it'll probably be easier for me than most people. So, you just take a spoon, like that. And I love cinnamon, I put it on my toast, I put it on my tea, everything, so. Me, cinnamon.
Cinnamon challenge. So I got hate mail after that as well. Thumbs up if you only clicked on this video because you thought she was going to Chalkook. All right. This is a long one. First up. You can't sing, nor like a black woman. You don't have to be big to sing like a bigger black woman. You can't sing, so stop. And you're beep because black women don't move their head. It's called having soul, which you will never have. This aunt is from a serious woman, a serious and now angry black woman, unlike you. One more. Beep you, Merdana! So, I have one more video to show to you guys this evening. And this one is really good because it applies to what we've been speaking on this evening, which is how to be a better person. And this actually should have been in my porn section earlier because it discusses a type of porn that we did not talk about yet, which is porn style dancing. Okay? You may have heard of a style of dancing called twerking, and I have made a video about it, so let's watch it together.
Hey guys, it's me, Miranda. So lots of you have been asking me for a twerking tutorial lately, and so I didn't know what that was, so I looked it up, and unfortunately, it's really a porn dance, so I'm doing my own version of twerking, because I think it's fun to be a sexy lady, but only if you're respectable. So, first things first, you need to warm up your body when you dance, otherwise you can pull a muscle, get hurt. So you don't get hurt when you're dancing. Every good dancer knows. Do a stretch, not a... So I'm going to do twerking without being porn. And I'm not going to show up my private parts, which is normal twerking. I'm going to do Miranda-style twerking. So there you go. That is twerking Miranda-style without being porn.
There you go. That's how to twerk it. Now you all know how to dance in the club this evening, I think. All right, let's get to the last bits of hate mail. You're so ugly, tau pice of chicken beep. You need to take off that lippy and get some booty. Why do you make videos? Because you cannot sing? You also might want to untie your top button because it makes you look like a gay man. Right, that's a compliment. The entire video, I was wondering how she was covering her monster-sized P-word. But right, on circle size. Miranda, I'm Little Russian Boy, and I say you are slut and ugly. This next one is the last hate mail I'm going to read for you guys this evening. It's a perfect example of a hater. What the beep you trying to do to people, Dread? You and scum kind of beeping mad people home. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Girl, hush your blasted mouth. Nah, Steve's only squawk, 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 squawk. You a beep parrot, hush. So what I say to those haters, I just say, haters, back off! And that usually does the trick. So you can use that to any type of bullies you have in your life, okay? Your moms, teachers, pets, carpets, uncles, anything. Just say, haters, back off, and it always does the trick for me. So we've discussed bullies. Let's go into the final topic of the evening, which is Miranda on self-esteem. So I love myself. And I think it's important that my Mirfandas love themselves too. So no matter who you are, where you came from, what you do, I think it's important that you love yourself. Unless you're not good, then do not, please. But some of you might not have high self-esteems. And it's my job as your mentor and teacher to tell you how to have a high self-esteem. And the number one way, I think, is to beat someone else at something to prove you're better than them. So, you know, there's a lot of YouTubers out there. And we have to do challenges all the time. You saw my cinnamon challenge. But there's lots of challenges that you guys make us do. There's the wasabi challenge, and there's the cinnamon challenge, and there's the milk challenge. There's all these different challenges. What you don't know is that most YouTubers cheat when they're doing challenges. They use avocado instead of wasabi. They use tomato juice instead of Tabasco sauce. They use cocoa powder instead of cinnamon, or they use 2% instead of whole milk. So there's a lot of cheaters out there, but I'm going to do a challenge right here on stage in front of your very eyes to prove that I'm better than any other YouTuber, and to prove that I'm not a cheater. Not only that, I'm going to beat one of you at the challenge. Oh, wow, there's a lot of pressure. Who wants to do it? And you right there. Oh, Sam. You know, I did look at you. You're beautiful. I know, I love your lipstick. All right, so, hello. Oh, you've got another porn shirt. Excuse me. What is your name?
Christine.
Oh, is this on? Let me make sure it's on for you, Christine. It is. Hello? Oh, it's on.
Hello.
All right, Christine. So we're going to do the Chubby Bunny Challenge. Have you heard of it?
Yes.
Okay. The Chubby Bunny Challenge, for those of you who don't know, is when you take a marshmallow and you stick it in your mouth, and then you say, Chubby Bunny! And you keep sticking them in your mouth. After every marshmallow, you say Chubby Bunny, and you do it until you can't do any more or you choke. So I have some marshmallows for us. Here's some marshmallows for you. And here's some marshmallows for me, so. Oh, and I have the small ones, because the big ones make me choke. So. Are you ready?
Yes.
Here we go. Number one. Chubby Bunny!
Chubby Bunny.
Two. Chubby Bunny!
Chubby Bunny.
Three. Chubby Bunny! Do not chew, it's cheating. Four. Can you do another one? You're done after three? Do you guys think she can do one more?
Yeah!
Four. Chubby Bunny!
Mm-hmm.
Are you done? I won. You did a great job. Give her a round of applause. What did you eat? Chunky. So, that's one way to help your self-esteem. Beat someone else at something, like I just did. Another way is to show off your talents all the time. Always be doing your talent, whatever that is. Fishing or soap, like I said. Whatever it is. Do your talent at all times to show off how talented you are, and that will help your self-esteem. So, there is one talent tonight that I have not done yet for you guys. Does anyone know what my one talent is? Magic, exactly. Woo! It's time for a magic trick, my friends. Woo! So, I'll bring my assistant Rachel Ballinger to the stage to help me. Alright, so, we're going to do a magic trick together. I got together with a magician named Chris Ballinger, and I asked him, magician, Chris, what is the one magic trick I can do to prove that I'm the best singer in the whole world? And he said, well, I can stick a sword in your neck. And I said, perfect. So we're going to take this thing, and it's going to go around my neck. Rachel's going to take the sword, take it out of its sheath. She's going to stick it through the hole, like so. Whilst I am singing, it will protrude in my neck, and it will not affect my singing at all. I still won't be perfect. Not only that, I'm going to be singing the hardest type of singing that there is, which is opera singing. I'm going to sing a song from my favorite opera of all time, which is Phantom of the Opera. And this song is called Think of Me. Hit it. Rich, you can stick it in you whenever you want. Think of me fondly when we say goodbye. Remember me trying too hard to part my mind. Think of me, please say, oh, think of me. Whenever I see a child's son, there will never be a day when I won't. Please promise me that sometimes you will think. did. I do have an encore prepared for you guys this evening. But first, I want to thank some people. I want to thank people who brought me here, here at Acme Comedy Club, Minneapolis. Don't forget to tip your waiters, because otherwise you don't. So I'd like to thank Josh, the bootiful man, for coming out, and Rachel, my assistant. I'd like to thank my Mirfandas for coming out. Last but not least, certainly not least, I'd like to thank myself. So thank you. So this last song I'm going to sing for you is dedicated to all my Mirfandas, because I love you so much, and I wouldn't be here without you, but I probably would. Yeah. Yes. Amen. 525,600 25,000 moments so deep. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee, in inches, in miles of laughter and strength. 525,600 minutes. Measure your life in the heart.